Welcome to our podcast, Touchdown Talk. I'm your host, Jordan, along here with...
Robert Hughes.
Connor Coppola.
And today we'll be talking about a number of things in the NFL, such as predictions for MVP and for Super Bowl 58 in Las Vegas and Allegiant Stadium. So we're going to start off with that. We're going to start off with Super Bowl predictions throughout Week 4. And we're going to start with Connor. Connor, who do you think is going to make the Super Bowl and go to Las Vegas throughout Week 4 and why?
Yeah, I think the 49ers are overwhelmingly the NFC favorite as of now. I mean, the way McCaffrey's playing, I think you could argue that he might even be an MVP potential candidate. I know we'll get to that a little later. But, I mean, Nick Bosa on defense, they're a well-coached team. And Brock Purdy, you wouldn't even think that he's the last pick in the NFL draft. He plays so fluid. Mm-hmm. And they're just a very cohesive unit. So I would pick the 49ers at the NFC. The AFC can get a little more tough. I mean, the Chiefs are always going to be there no matter what. It's kind of like just tough to pick against Mahomes nowadays. I would say I'm going to do a little surprise pick here. I'm going to go with the Baltimore Ravens, though. I want to be a little different. I like the way they're playing. Obviously, the Dobbins injury has hurt them, but, I mean, Lamar is throwing the ball just as good as any other quarterback, and, of course, he's so dynamic with his feet. So I would love to see a Ravens-49ers matchup. A little... it was 10 years ago, I believe, right? The Harbaugh.
Obviously,
Jim Harbaugh's no longer coaching the 49ers, but I think that would be a great matchup, and that would be my prediction.
So Connor has the Baltimore Ravens
coming
out of the AFC and the 49ers coming out of the NFC.
Yes,
Robert,
sir.
Who do you think is going to go to Las Vegas?
Connor, I'm not copying you. I also picked the 49ers for the NFC. I mean, the defense is insane. Nick Bosa, like you said, I mean, George Kittle's one of the best weapons in the league. Brock Purdy, when he's healthy and... you know, when he's playing well, when he's on his game, he's a pretty underrated quarterback. So I picked them from the NFC. I'd love to pick my Packers, but I don't think Jordan Love is the answer right now. He's a little shaky. But for the AFC, I'll probably go with the Dolphins. Their offense is just high-flying. I mean, Tua, you love to watch lefty quarterbacks play, especially a guy that just throws it like every play. And you have Waddle, Tyreek Hill, the two running backs, Raheem Mostert and Chain or whatever how you say his name, but yeah, they're really just a great offensive team. I think it's going to be hard to stop them. They put up like 30 points a game.
So you have the Miami Dolphins coming out of the AFC and then the 49ers coming out of the NFC.
That's right.
My prediction, I'm gonna go same with the NFC like you guys. I'm gonna go with the 49ers. I think Brock Purdy, he's undefeated in the regular season right now. Christian McCaffrey is having an unbelievable season. He's a top rusher right now. Their defense really good, and I think as long as everybody stays healthy, they're going to go to Las Vegas. And the AFC, I'm going to stick with the Chiefs. The Chiefs are just they you can't count them out. They're like
juggernaut.
Exactly. They're just juggernaut. They're like they're the team to beat in the AFC. I think how they were like the Patriots a while back, you know, a different team now, but you know, they're that team to beat in the AFC, and I think it's going to be the 49ers versus the Kansas City Chiefs. All right, guys, we're going to go straight to predictions for MVP this season throughout Week 4. Connor, who do you think is going to be the most valuable player at the end of the NFL season?
Well, you were pretty boring with your Super Bowl prediction, so I'll be the one who makes things entertaining here. I'll go with Micah Parsons. I think that is just a fun pick. He's maybe the most influential non-quarterback in the NFL right now. I think the way he just wrecks games on defenses, like you see him pretty much every single play.
He wrecked my Patriots, so yeah.
He wrecks every team.
Every team.
I mean, he is truly one of those players that literally and figuratively jumps off the television screen when you watch him. So I think he would have to do something really, really incredible. Either that's break the sack record or the Cowboys have an all-time defense in terms of points allowed. But yeah, instead of it being a quarterback like it is almost every single year, I'll pick Micah Parsons, first defensive player to win since Lawrence Taylor.
I like that pick. Who do you think is going to be most valuable player at the end of the season, Robert?
I mean, right now, I think Tua is in a great spot to do it. He has, I think, 9 touchdowns and 3 picks. And, I mean, of course, like I alluded to before, he always throws, and his team puts up a lot of points every game. Also, Jalen Hurts, I think, from the Eagles. He probably should have won it last year. And, yeah, I think... I mean, he runs a lot. He's a really dynamic player. I think it's time for him to get one.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go with Robert on this one. I think it's going to be Tua. I know Connor doesn't like, you know, another quarterback being MVP, but sorry, Connor. I think that's just how it's going to go.
Tua's a good pick.
Tua's been playing amazing, and he's healthy unlike last season. And as long as he stays healthy, I think he's going to be MVP.
See, you brought up a very important point, if he stays healthy. Now, we're not encouraging gambling on this podcast, but I believe he's the odds-on favorite. And... he is playing at an unreal level. That Dolphins offense is probably the funnest offense to watch in the NFL right now. Does it worry you, though, if you were a gambling man, you were putting a substantial amount of money on this, that one head blow, one sack hits his head on the turf the wrong way, and that could be a season over? Does that worry you guys?
A little bit. I mean, yeah, he's an injury-prone guy, but, you know, I mean, I think the O-line is playing better this year. I mean, last year, it seemed like every play he was under pressure, I think, I mean, he'll be fine.
Yeah, Rob brings up a good point. I think that is a good point because the O-line is playing great this year, and I don't know. I think two of them might have it. All right, let's go straight into the
two-minute
drill.
Dun, dun, dun.
And pretty much what we're going to be doing is we're just going to have teams you guys will see on the screen, and we're going to try and match which player played for both teams in the NFL.
Yeah, so it's the popular Immaculate Grid game, so we're just going to have 2 minutes to get it done, I guess, and see if we could do it.
Play
if
it
you
want to
start
long.
A timer,
for sure. Yeah.
Quick 2 minute timer.
Start a timer.
See if all right, can get
Rob.
It
I'm gonna go 3-2. Okay.
Yep.
You ready? 2 minutes starting Time. Now.
All right. Here we go. So we got Saints, Browns.
Played
for both of those teams.
Saints and Browns played for both of them. I mean, that's
Jarvis Landry. Yep.
Wide receiver. Hmm. I don't even know if he's on a team anymore.
I don't know where he is.
He was really good back in the day.
Saints, Titans. Who would that be? Also a Saints 1,000-yard rusher.
Ricky Williams.
Ricky Williams.
Go with that quickly. Got to get this done quickly.
Got this, Connor. Doing good.
Saints and Titans. I don't know.
Oh, Adrian Peterson.
Yeah, he did play for the Titans. Good one, Rob. That's a really good guess. Adrian Peterson. I believe last non-quarterback to an MVP, too.
Right, yeah. Falcons-Browns. Who would that be?
Hunter Henry ever play for the Falcons?
No. Falcons-Browns. Austin Hooper?
That's who I was thinking of.
There you go.
That's who I was thinking of. You know, these white tight ends, they all look the same. So
great tight end, by the way.
Okay, here we go. And then Falcons, Titans, Julio Jones, right?
Yeah, wow, you're on fire.
Okay. Rob's on fire with this one. This is Rob's game.
We got to get
right
this
off
done.
The cuff.
Let's see.
We got 1 minute left,
we got
boys.
A little left, a little left.
Falcons, 1,000-yard rusher.
Tyler Allgeier did it last year, but you could be safe and do Devontae Freeman, yeah.
Okay,
it's a good one.
I think Tyler Allgeier did it last year.
And here we go. So Raiders, Browns, actually.
Raiders and the Browns.
That's a tough one.
Brian Hoyer. Wait. I don't know if Brian Hoyer's played for the Raiders. I know he's on the Raiders, but I don't know if he played for the Raiders.
Remember that backup, Gradkowski? Did he do it? The quarterback?
I don't know.
No idea. We'll come back to that. So Raiders, Titans.
Raiders, Titans.
Vic Beasley?
Did he play for the Raiders?
Let's go, boys.
Go for it.
15 seconds left.
Okay. Raiders, 1,000-yard rusher. Josh Jacobs, right?
Yeah, quick.
10 seconds.
And okay, then Raiders, Browns, last one.
5, 4, 3.
The pressure's getting
two.
To me.
Oh, no, we cannot do it.
Any last right. guess? Last guess, real quick?
I was going to say Brian Hoyer, but I don't think he's played for the Raiders
let's
yet.
Let's try it.
He's on the Raiders.
He did.
Oh, all
we
right. Well,
done it.
Little delay game penalty there, but we got it done, so.
We'll count it.
Good job, boys.
That's a very, very good
All right, that's a wrap for our Touchdown Talk podcast. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and our YouTube. You guys can watch our podcast there.